the Canada Worker Lockdown Benefit would provide $300 a week to workers who are subject to a lockdown, including those who are ineligible for employment insurance.
Ottawa scaling back financial supports for Canadians and businesses impacted by the pandemic. The Canada Recovery Benefit will expire this Saturday and be replaced by a program meant for workers facing local lockdowns.
We estimate the total cost of these measures from October 24th through to May 7th of next year will be $7.4 billion.
The new Canada Worker Lockdown Benefit will run until May 7th, 2022. The CRB, which replaced the Canada Emergency Response Benefit, provided workers who lost 50% of their income because of COVID up to $500 a week. Freeland also announcing a rollback of supports for businesses impacted by the pandemic. The Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy and Rent Subsidy will also be expiring this weekend, replaced with a new program.
The hardest hit business recovery program will be available to employers who can show they have faced deep and enduring losses and will provide support through the wage and rent subsidy programs.
That program will be accompanied by another new support for the tourism industry, the Tourism and Hospitality Recovery Program. Ottawa, again, focusing on the possibility of local lockdowns in return for support.
For those businesses that face temporary local lockdowns, we will make the wage and rent subsidy available up to the maximum amount for the duration of the local lockdown.
But not everyone is confident in the new measures.
Only 40% of small businesses are generating normal revenues.
The rent subsidy and lockdown supports have helped more than 210,000 organizations, more than $6.8 billion in support.
Setting up limits or thresholds such as, you know, revenue loss of 40 or 50% will leave many businesses without support.
The Fed's also announcing they will be extending the Canada Recovery Sickness Benefit and Caregiving Benefit until May 7th, 2022. In Ottawa, Nigel Newlove, City News.